G'day and welcome to Aussie Tech. And today I'm looking at the Navman MyView 540. Now this is a in-car camera recording unit for in case little things happen on the road, like I do. If you want to check out my Drive Safe Australia channel to see footage that I get. Now this one is a camera that retails around 172. This is one of the more cheaper ones. I thought I'd give one a go. It's actually a present I gave my brother for Christmas. Now it's not a bad little unit. One thing I do like about it is that to fix it to the window, it's through a suction cap instead of a lot of them where you have to fix them to the window and that's it. You can't move them in and out. I would like to be able to do that. So it's quite a simple little unit. It's got a USB power connection, has got a HDMI out. That, not sure if anyone there uses it. It does actually record pretty good audio, and it's all touchscreen. Records in 1080p. And it's not bad. So what we're going to do now is, sorry that's a bit out of focus there, but we're going to have a look now at some of the footage. Let's see the difference. Now the first footage, this is from it itself. This is from the Navman. Not too bad. It's a bit of a narrow field of view. It's not too wide. It's still pretty good. The colours are quite good. Not much noise in this kind of light. Now I'm going to move over to the Blackview 650, just a bit of comparison. It does show a little bit more information in the bottom left there. The Navman you'll see in the bottom right, you'll see information about what camera it is and some settings. Now here we are again. Now we're still on the Blackview and we're going to change to the Navman. Here we are now. Now we see a little bit of information that provides the right side speed, your location, coordinates, and what camera it is there, so that you can turn that on and off if you don't want to. Here we are now, we're back with the Blackview. Just want to show a little bit of a difference in footage now that it's starting to get dark, so I thought this would be a good way to see what the difference is. And I'm surprised that the colour from the Navman is pretty good, but its low light starts to get a lot more noisy than what the Blackview can do. So here we are now. Now Blackview is a lot more expensive car camera. Now on the Navman, we're going off at the satellites here, and it's starting to get darker here, and you're starting to see more darkness and more noise in the picture. You move over to the Blackview, that you do seem to get a bit more detail, and it seems to be less affected by as it gets dark. So there you go. Now I'm going to be quiet for a second. I know it's hard for me, but I'm going to be quiet for a second. So we're going to be going to the nighttime now, and I'm just going to see what the audio is like from the camera. Now we're doing a test of the audio quality from the unit. It was actually, from what I can believe, is actually not too bad. So audio quality is not too bad. Now we're at night, and this is where you really do see that there's a lot more noise in the picture. It's still usable. It's probably not really usable for if you want to use this for driving videos, but definitely usable in case of something happens on the road. You have some footage of that. What's my view? Now for the price, it's actually not a bad little unit. It's definitely not going to cut it with the Blackview, but that's a $650 camera. But for its price and point, the Navman is actually not bad. I'm actually quite impressed with it. It does have GPS, it does let you know what your speed is, and for under $200, not a bad little unit. So definitely worth checking out if you're after a cheap car camera, which I recommend everyone should have. Oh, hope you all had a Merry Christmas.